What's going on, everyone? It's Justin here, and today I've got the last and final episode of the Holiday Tech Gift Guide with items priced over $1,000. So these are items that I believe are the best on the market in each category. So we have some cameras, computers, smartphones, even a drone. And even though we are at the price point of $1,000 to unlimited, I have tried to keep value in mind for a couple products as well, especially the cameras. If you guys missed it, I did do three other gift guides covering different price points, which start at the $25 to $50 and under, moving up to $100 and $200 and under, a best tech under $1,000 and under $500, so all of those are going to be linked down below, but now we've reached the last episode. If you guys haven't entered already, I do have an iPhone XR giveaway ending soon for the holiday season, so check that link down below and make sure you're subscribed to the channel, drop a like on this video, and also drop a comment down below. And make sure you follow me over on Instagram and Twitter, as that's where I'm going to be announcing the winner once it ends. As always, all the products mentioned in this video are going to be linked down below. So I think one of the best gifts to give at this price point is a drone, and here is the DJI Mavic 2 Pro that just came out, and it comes in at a price of just under $1,500, although I do recommend getting the Fly More bundle as well. If you're looking to get something maybe a little bit cheaper, the Mavic Air is also an excellent option at its lower price point and still shoots 4K, but if you know someone who's doing professional video and wants something that has great video quality but also comes at a size that is still portable and easy to set up and use, then the Mavic 2 line, whether it's the Pro or Zoom, is an option that you can't go wrong with. The Mavic 2 Pro is my pick, and it has a 20 megapixel CMOS 1-inch Hasselblad sensor. The 31 minute battery life is pretty good and more than enough to get some good footage on each charge, and has many smart features, with some of them including active track, the ability to shoot panoramic photos, hyperlapse, and most importantly for me at least is object avoidance, which is omnidirectional so you don't crash this thing. If you're looking for a great Windows computer to give, the Microsoft Surface line for 2018 is a great choice, whether it's a Surface Pro 6 that we have right here, the 2-in-1 setup, or the Surface laptop. I personally always really enjoyed the line just because the hardware is really nice. It's something that looks great, feels very durable on an everyday basis if you want to take it around, especially the kickstand on this feels rugged, and it's just hardware that you can trust. The Surface Pro 6 has a base storage option of 128 gigs and can go all the way up to 1 TB, and you do have the choice between 8 or 16 gigs of RAM or an i5 or i7 processor option. I'm also a pretty big fan of the black color that came out for 2018, and it does have full day battery life and weighs in at under 2 pounds. As for smartphones on the Android side, some of which are getting very expensive, and in a lot of cases, it is very unjustified, but I think one phone that has really justified its features and value at around the $1,000 price point is the Samsung Galaxy Note 9. It's probably one of the most feature-packed phones that I reviewed this year, and I'm very excited to see what Samsung does next year. But the Note 9 has a Snapdragon 845 processor with 6 gigs of RAM and 128 gigs of storage, paired with a beautiful 6.4-inch Quad HD Plus Super AMOLED display with a 2960x1440 resolution. And you're also not going to find a notch and still have a headphone jack on the bottom. But aside from all the great hardware, the S Pen is still one of the most compelling features of this phone, and this year it also works as a remote. There's just so many uses for the pen, whether it's on the creative or productivity side, that would take me a long time to go over. You also have a dual 12 megapixel camera, which is one of the best on the market, as well as an 8 megapixel front-facing camera, and the 4000 mAh battery will last you all day. On the camera side of things, my two picks for this year are from the Sony side. So I do use a Canon camera, but I believe in terms of value, you're getting a much better bang for buck on the Sony side. For my uses, I personally prefer Canon's quality and still feel like it is worth it, but the Sony a6500 is an impressive camera for the money. You can get this thing with a 16-50 kit lens for under $1,400, and it shoots 4K 30, has 5-axis stabilization, and also the ability to record slow motion 120 frames per second at 1080p. It's an APS-C 24 megapixel sensor, but it's great for both photo and video, and for anyone who's just starting to get a little bit serious with the production side of things, this is a camera that should last you many years. A very easy pick for professionals is a Sony a7 III, which is arguably the best camera that came out this year. Mirrorless cameras have become really popular in the past few years due to their form factor, and this right here for the price of under $2,000 with the body only is a great buy. You have a 24 megapixel full frame sensor with 5-axis stabilization, the ability to record 4K 30 and 1080p 120, and it also focuses super fast with almost 700 focus points. And one of the biggest complaints I've had in the past with Sony cameras is bad battery life, and this has been improved in the a7 III. If you're looking for the best tablet on the market, I think there's really no option other than the iPad Pro 2018. And this year, many of the improvements I think are very, very good. You have a screen that goes edge to edge and looks amazing with the 120 hertz refresh. You've got the Apple A12X processor that is powering this thing, which gives it very good performance, and you guys might have seen me do some video editing on it. And I feel like for a lot of people, this is gonna actually be your main machine, whether you're in the business world, the finance world, medical field, in production, photography, video. Although it definitely needs some work in terms of software to kind of take advantage of the full capabilities of the iPad. I think a lot of the available apps at the moment do take advantage of the power of this iPad. But of course, it doesn't come in cheap, and at this price point with the keyboard and the pencil added, you do kind of have to pick between a laptop or an iPad at that same price. One of the pieces of tech that I was most excited for when it arrived this year is a Surface Studio 2, and I kind of consider this an ultimate gift. Microsoft just did an amazing job engineering it, designing it, the hinges, the hardware, and everything about it in an all-in-one computer is there. But without a doubt, with great design, it definitely comes at a cost. Design was already impressive in the previous generation, but I think the biggest change they made this year was improved specs to have the full capable power of a professional computer. You have an i7 processor, 32 gigs of RAM, and up to 2 terabytes of storage. You have a 28-inch PixelSense display, and it's just very versatile in the fact that you can use it as just your normal computer, but also fold it flat and use it as a touchscreen or drawing board, which gives you a large slate to work with. There's just so many things you could do with a touchscreen, and it is essentially like a large tablet and a nicer version of a Wacom tablet. As someone who personally loves Apple, I personally don't like the way the iMac looks at all, and I think this Microsoft Surface Studio 2 looks amazing. The pen is definitely a must-have accessory, and the dial is one of those where if you think you'll use it, then get it, but if not, I don't really think it's a necessity. On the Apple side of things, the computer that I can recommend this year is a 13-inch MacBook Pro with Touch Bar. So previously I had a little bit of troubles recommending this for everybody because of the fact that it had a dual core processor. But this year you do have a quad core processor in the i5 and i7 variant, up to 16 gigs of RAM, which is really nice to see. And the storage on this is fast. The hardware is very well built. You have a beautiful display, 4 Thunderbolt 3 ports, and overall a pretty good battery life. And I think this is a computer that is great for anyone who's doing general productivity work, but also needs a little bit more power than just the average user. I will admit though, it is very expensive, but I personally picked up a refurbished one to use as my backup computer in the i7 and 1 terabyte option, and I think it's a pretty good buy. If you're in the market to buy a nice new TV for someone, maybe a family TV that you can use for many years, my personal favorite is the Samsung QLED line. This line comes in a few different sizes, but it does 4K, obviously HDR, and I believe it's just a very good future-proof option. It's the one that I have in my living room, and I really like it not only because it has great picture quality and is nice and bright, the colors look amazing, but I also really like the way the TV is designed, and it looks great whether you just have it in your living room or you're wall mounting it. If you guys enjoyed this video, make sure you drop a like, and now that it's the end of the year, I would really like to hear if you guys had any suggestions for videos that we should do, ways we can improve our content, our quality, and kind of the setup. We are kind of trying to figure out what to do with that set right there and finally retire it. Not too different, but at least a little bit of change because I'm sure you guys have seen the same set for a while now. We are going to be heading to CES in a couple weeks, but I hope you guys have a great holiday season, and I'll see you in the next video.